Hey everyone, it's Jackson from Talos. I hope you're all doing really well. Today what we're going to be talking about is how you can convert an entire block of text into an audio file. Now last time what we talked about was converting specific lines into speech, but what we're going to be doing this time is taking an entire book and making it into an audio file that you can convert and listen to on your phone. This is really useful because you can listen to this while you're cooking and away from your computer or doing something else like that. It's really easy, so let's jump right in. Alright, so what I have here is an ebook from Project Gutenberg, which is a really cool site that basically has free public domain books in text form. So what we're going to do is we're going to try to convert this entire book, The Adventures of Tom Sawyer, into an audio form that we can read on anything we want. First of all, we're going to go and we're going to select the entire section that we want to be read. Double click the word you want to start with. We're going to go all the way down until right here. And we're going to select all that. So we're going to either control click it or two finger click it. And we're going to get to the services menu. And then it's going to say add to iTunes as a spoken track. And we're going to click on that. Now we want the system voice to be Ava. So we're going to leave that there. We're going to name this Tom Sawyer. And we're going to leave it in the music folder. We can test our voice by clicking play.
Isn't it nice to have a computer that will talk to you?
And if you want the voice to be faster or slower, you go to System Preferences by hitting Command plus Space and hitting Enter, and then go to Speech by typing in Speech, and then click on Speech, and then you can change how fast your computer speaks or how slow it speaks, and you can test it there. I went over this in a previous video, which I'll link in the video and in the description. Now, close out of that, and then what we're going to do is we're just going to hit Continue, and the book should be processing. You'll see this little gear icon in the menu. That means that the book is processing. If something goes wrong, you can always click this little X at the top. Now, just while it's processing, I should note that this is going to take quite a while if it's a very large book, which this is a very large book. If that doesn't work, for example, if you, for some reason, don't have a services menu or you don't have the add to iTunes as a spoken track service, what you can do is you can copy it, which we did by hitting Command plus C or right clicking and hitting copy. Then what you do is you hit Command plus Space, you hit Text, Edit, and you hit Enter, and it'll open up this menu, and you just hit New Document. It may automatically open on your computer, depending on what you're doing. And then just right-click and hit Paste, or hit Command plus V, and it'll paste the entire thing into there, okay? Now what you do is you hit Command plus A, which selects everything in the entire document, and then you do the exact same thing. Right-click, Services, Add to iTunes as Spoken Track. I already have done this, so I don't really need to. The gear icon's already moving. I'm just going to skip ahead until we're ready. So at some point, the gear icon is just going to disappear, and iTunes will open up and start processing. Also, during that process, something might come up, like an error sign that says there's something wrong with the recording. I don't think that that actually is true. I've had that happen multiple times to me, and nothing bad has happened. All right, so if you go to Recently Added, right here in the top left corner, you'll be able to see your audiobook right there. And so you can just hit play.
Preface, most of the adventures.
And so you'll see it's a 6.5 hour long audiobook. So it's clearly the entire thing. And you can skip around and you can play it and do all the things you would do with a normal iTunes song. But there's a few things that I want to show you that are a little bit different. So first of all, what we're going to do is we're going to change the type of file that it is. So let's say that I'm listening to Tom Sawyer and I'm 4 hours and 2 minutes in and I decided I need a break. I just want to, you know, close my computer or I have to go to sleep. So I quit iTunes and then I restart my computer. The next morning I decide I want to listen to Tom Sawyer. The problem is,
preface,
it starts at the very beginning again, which is not helpful for an audiobook unless you want to write down every time you stop where you were last listening to. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to change the way that this book is read. So I'm going to right click on Tom Sawyer and I'm going to hit Song Info. Okay. And then I'm going to go to Options, which is a tab in the top bar. And then I'm going to change the media kind from music to audiobook. As you have this now, you can change a few of the different features. You can say, remember playback position, which is what we're talking about. It'll remember now where you last listened. And then you can also skip when shuffling. This basically means that when you're shuffling music or when you're listening to music on shuffle, it won't play your audiobook. Because if you're shuffling music, if you're listening to a bunch of different songs, you don't want Tom Sawyer to automatically pop up while you're in the middle of, say, your workout or something like that. You also have the option to change the equalizer, which, you know, you can do. You can play around with it. I've never really found that all that useful, so I'm just not going to do that. And then you can just click OK. Now, it'll disappear, and that might seem a little bit scary. You might be wondering where it went. All you have to do is go to the search bar and type in Tom Sawyer, and it's in the audiobook section of your Mac, which if you go to the tab up here, top left corner, and you click on audiobooks, that's where it'll be. So now, we can listen to it.
Most of the adventures,
and if we're halfway through,
he would lead a life of
and we pause it, and we quit, and then we open back iTunes again, it will remember exactly where we were. So let's go to Tom Sawyer, and hit enter, and then hit play.
Prime. There we-
and it remembers exactly where we were. So I'm going to right-click on Tom Sawyer. I'm going to click Add to Playlist. I'm going to create a new playlist called My Audio Books. I'm going to hit enter, and it'll be this nice playlist right here. So I'm going to plug in my phone right now. You'll see a little phone icon pop up right next to the Audiobooks tab. I'm going to click on that, and it might be syncing. I'm not sure yet. Yeah, I'm going to cancel that sync because I want to do some other stuff before it syncs. Then I'm going to go to the Audiobooks tab under my phone, and I'm going to make sure that Sync Audiobooks is checked. Okay. Now what I'm going to do is under the Audiobooks section, or under the Include Audiobooks from Playlist section, rather, I'm going to go to My Audiobooks and check that. So now it will automatically sync any audiobooks that are in that audiobook section playlist. I'm going to hit Apply, and it's going to sync it automatically. And then as soon as this is done, I'll open it up on my phone and I'll show you exactly how you can listen to it. All right, so when you turn on your phone, you should have an app somewhere called iBooks. If you can't find that, just swipe down and type in iBooks and it'll pop up and just click on that. And then you should get to this context menu. If you don't, what you can do is you can hit All Books or wherever is there instead and make sure that All Books is in fact checked. And you'll have The Adventures of Tom Sawyer by Mark Twain right here. And you can click on that and it'll start playing.
Save them. Then the sobs came thick and fast. Just at this point he met his soul.
And you can pause it. Now this is really nice because you can also speed up the playback speed all the way up until 2 times.
Sworn comrade, Joe Harper.
You can also slow it down to 0.75 speed. And you can also do something which is really nice, which I really like, called the sleep timer. So you can start playing it, and then after 10 minutes, it'll just stop playing. So I like using that when I'm going to bed. I actually listen to my audiobook, and then as I'm falling asleep, you know, I don't want to be listening to something all night. So after 10 or so minutes, I'll be asleep, and the audiobook will actually stop. All right, so that about wraps it up from our end. We hope you've enjoyed this video. If you have any specific questions, definitely leave a comment below. Also, don't forget to like and subscribe and share this video with any friends that you think might need it. We hope to hear from you soon.